peaks and troughs is not how you build a business, because that's what has you flatlining at the same revenue level that you've probably been stuck at for the last couple of years. So having a system and process in place, and then allowing yourself to win that work, and then having that system and process to run the BD behind you, will mean, you know, that your business is growing. Hi team. So I want to talk to you about how to win more work. So fresh off a discussion from our boardroom coaching program earlier, talking with our amazing clients about all things business development, all things winning work, and really how to guarantee that you're going to be able to win more work and increase your project pipeline. And the few things that I want to talk to you about today that's come out of an amazing discussion with an incredible bunch of clients. So the first thing is that you absolutely have to have a plan when it comes to business development and winning work. Like, you can't, it's one of my clients was like, oh, I don't really have a plan. It's all just kind of up here in my head. And I was like, you can't leave it all up there in your head. As you get busier, as your business grows, and this is one of the common things that I see in our industry and in our marketplace, is that people go through ebbs and flows. Like, their business is going really well, then it goes like peaks and troughs in their business. And it's because, you know, they go through a period of intense business development and they're winning a whole bunch of work. But then as they get busy, their focus on business development drops off. And so the discussion today was about, how do you keep the momentum? How do you maintain the momentum of business development happening in the background while you're still steering the ship? And so what we talked through today was like a really simple kind of system for business development, calling it the traffic light system, in terms of red, green, and yellow, and actually having a plan in place for clients and different types of clients in each of those different phases within your business development process. And looking at ways where, and I said this to my clients, as your business grows, you essentially need to do everything yourself, like startup through to, doesn't matter what phase, every new initiative you do, everything new that you do in your business, you need to do yourself first, because you need to know it, need to understand it, need to understand the intricacies of it, need to be involved in tweaking that process before you hand it off to someone else. But as soon as you become the bottleneck for that process, as soon as you become the constraint within that process or opportunity in your business, you then need to look at ways to systemize it, to delegate it, and to get other people to help you with that in your business. And so one of the like examples that we used today was, you know, on the red, so in terms of the traffic light was business development. Green are hot opportunities that you pursue, you know, they're the first things that you pursue when it comes to business development. Yellow are, you know, like kind of opportunities that are 50-50. There might be some referrals. They might be like following up on old proposals. There might be like opportunities with clients that you already know and have a relationship with, but it's not a green, like it's not a hot opportunity. And red is like, these people don't know you from a bar of soap, and you know, there's no relationship there at all. And so it's important to have a strategy for each of these different areas within your business, green, yellow, and red. And what are you doing every single day to move those forward? Or what are your team doing every single day to move those forward? And we talked a lot about, in the red, there are systems and processes and softwares that you can actually build into your business to automate a lot of the red things so that you're not having to do it. But as an example, like, you're running all of the red things, the red business development strategy first, until such time as that you're completely overwhelmed with chat messages on LinkedIn, as an example, or bidding on projects, or putting in proposals, or having conversations, or requests for meetings, that sort of stuff. You run all of that until you become the bottleneck, and then you work out a way to then systemize that or have someone else run that for you. And so what we talked about today was the importance of momentum in business development and consistency. So like I talked about at the start of this video, you know, businesses go through these peaks and troughs because you're winning, you're a big BD focus, you win a heap of work, then you move into delivery, your focus goes off business development. You know, you put your head up, and in 3 months' time, you're like, oh man, got no work. So you go back into BD, And it's these constant peaks and troughs. And that is not how you grow a sustainable business. So it's about looking at actually formulating a proper business development strategy for the greens, for the yellows, and the red, and looking at ways to have those run for you or without your constant input. So it means as you grow or as you win more work, the work winning is happening and the business development is happening. And so you're not plateauing at the same revenue level in those peaks and troughs of delivery and, you know, feast and famine kind of thing, but you're actually growing. You know, more work's coming on, you're delivering that work, your business development strategy is still running in the background, you're still getting opportunities to quote on projects and that sort of thing. And so your business is growing because you've got systems and processes in your business that are running that BD strategy for you as you're delivering or as you're focusing on other things. So a key importance here is first have a plan. Know what you're doing in the traffic light scenario in terms of green, yellow, and red in your business. What can you automate? What can run without you? What needs your input? What is going to need your input until you become the bottleneck? And then who are you going to delegate to? Or what software or system are you going to replace you with? And then that's how you build momentum. That's how you grow a business. And that is how you win more work. It's not about these lumps and peaks and troughs. It is about being smart initially, working out a strategy, getting it out of your head so that you're not the bottleneck. You've got a clear BD strategy for your business, and then you've got a system and process in place that runs it for you. That's how you build a business. Peaks and troughs is not how you build a business, because that's what has you flatlining at the same revenue level that you've probably been stuck at for the last couple of years. So having a system and process in place and then allowing yourself to win that work and then having that system and process to run the BD behind you will mean, you know, that your business is growing. So that's what I want to talk about today, team. That's, you know, we've just fresh out of discussion with everyone in our boardroom program about that. An amazing conversation. And so, you know, if you want to keep doing this journey on your own, we've got heaps of free resources, the podcast, the website, the YouTube channel for you to keep building your business on your own. But if you'd like some help building your business with an amazing community of people, just comment the word boardroom or send me an email with the word boardroom in it. And let's have a chat about how I can help you build your business faster. Have an amazing day.